Ukraine crisis. NATO top general says truce in name only. NATO's most senior military commander has said the ceasefire between Ukraine and pro-Russian separatists currently exists in name only. Jet Philip Breedlove said the numbers of artillery rounds fired recently was comparable to periods before the truce came into effect 2 weeks ago. He added, however, that he was hopeful about a new agreement signed in the early hours of Saturday. Ukraine accuses Russia of arming separatists, but Russia denies this. More than 3,000 people have died in fighting in two eastern regions since April. The truce was agreed on September 5, but there have been repeated violations since then. Russian returned Jen Breedlove, NATO's supreme Allied commander in Europe, was speaking after a meeting with NATO military chiefs in Vilnius, Lithuania. The situation in Ukraine is not good right now, he told reporters. The number of events, and the number of rounds fired and the artillery used across the past few days match some of the pre-ceasefire levels. The ceasefire is still there in name, but what is happening on the ground is quite a different story, he added. He said that since last week, some Russian forces inside Ukraine had returned to Russia but remained available to bring their military force to bear on Ukraine. NATO has plans to bolster its military presence in countries bordering Russia, including the Baltic states, which used to be part of the Soviet bloc. Jen Breedlove praised a new 9-point ceasefire memorandum which was signed in Minsk on Saturday morning. The deal was reached after late-night talks between representatives of Ukraine, Russia, Eastern separatists and the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe OSCE. The agreement includes setting up a 30-kilometer 19-mile buffer zone, a ban on overflights of part of eastern Ukraine by military aircraft and the withdrawal of foreign mercenaries on both sides. Moscow has repeatedly denied sending Russian troops to Ukraine or arming Ukrainian separatists. The Russian government says that any Russians fighting inside Ukraine are doing so in a private capacity.